What's up, guys? It's MB Boxing. I just finished up watching Juan Francisco Estrada versus Roman Chocolatito Gonzalez 3. And this was a 12-rounder for the vacant WBC super-flyweight world championship. And this fight was Saturday, December 3rd, from the Gila River Arena in Glendale, Arizona. And this fight was broadcasted on DAZN. And in this fight, Juan Francisco Estrada was able to get a majority decision victory over Roman Chocolatito Gonzalez. So I personally scored this bout 115 to 113 in favor of Chocolatito. So the thing is, I thought this fight was very, very competitive, obviously a very, very good fight, just like all of the other fights they've had. But I thought that Chocolatito edged it. And I could definitely see how some people could say this is a robbery, and I actually kind of think that it is, even though it was a very close and competitive fight. So the three judges scored this bout 114 to 114, even a draw. And the other two had it in favor of Estrada, scoring at 116 to 112 and 115 to 113. So those are the exact scorecards I predicted for this fight, but I thought that Chocolatito was going to get the decision, but he did not. But the thing is, just to break this fight down round by round, early on, Chocolatito, I'm going to be honest, he didn't really look that good. Estrada was just outworking and outboxing him in rounds 1 through 5. I mean, they were really just clear, or not even, they weren't clear rounds, all of them, for Estrada, but 4 out of those 5 rounds in the first 5 were really, really clear for Estrada. I mean, the thing is, rounds 1, 2, 4, and 5, Estrada was just outboxing Chocolatito on the outside, landing the far better shots, and he won those rounds clearly, no question. But then in the third round, that was a really close round that could have went either way. And they were exchanging with big shots, both of them. And it was a really fun round, but I thought that Chocolatito actually landed the slightly better shots and more effective shots in that third round. But then in round number 6, Chocolatito started to pick it up. And on my scorecard from round 6 up until round 11, I gave all those rounds to Roman Chocolatito Gonzalez. The thing is, in those rounds, Chocolatito just started to come forward, and he did much more than Estrada. Estrada, it looked like he started to slow down a bit, and Chocolatito started to pick it up. The rounds were still fun. Some of them were actually more dominant in favor of Chocolatito, specifically like round 10. That was a big round for Chocolatito. He was just backing up Estrada, and he was actually able to bloody up the nose of Estrada a little bit. But still, I mean, those rounds were really, really fun. Both of them were throwing big combinations, exchanging, but in most of those rounds from 6 through 11 on my scorecard, or in all of those rounds from 6 through 11, Chocolatito had them, he won them, and I thought that he was just doing the much better work coming forward, and it looked like it was like a resurgence compared to his work in the first couple rounds of the fight, because he just wasn't really doing enough. But then in the latter half, I mean, he really picked up the pace and really, in my opinion, those rounds won him this fight. But then in round number 12, it was a really, really close round, a really, really great round. This round clearly could have went either way. I mean, this round, I gave it to Estrada, but it really could have went in Chocolatito's favor. Both of them were throwing massive shots. They were exchanging, trying to settle it out in the center of the ring in the last round. But I slightly thought that Estrada had the better shots, but it was a really, really good round. So if you were scoring this fight, comment down below how you scored it, because I'm very, very interested to see how some other people have it. But, nonetheless, I think that Chocolatito should have won this fight. I'm going to be honest. When I heard 116 to 112, I thought they were going to give it to Chocolatito. I kind of think that 116-112 for Estrada is kind of impossible because of how clearly Chocolatito won the rounds from 6 through 11, in my opinion. The two really, really close rounds that could go either way, in my opinion, were the third round and the 12th round. But the 12th round I gave to Estrada, third round I gave to Chocolatito. So let's just say I give the third round to Estrada on my scorecard, that would be a draw. So, I mean, really, I'm going to be honest, the closest I think this fight could be, in my opinion, is a draw. Maybe I have to rewatch it and see how close these rounds were actually, if it could sway my opinion, who knows. But, I mean, as of now, I have it 115-113. Chocolatito, and it could actually even be like 116 to 112 or something like that. But this goes in the question, what is next for Juan Francisco Estrada? Definitely one thing that could be next is a quadrilogy. I know that it's very, very, like, it's not that often that these happen, and it's very unlikely. But, I mean, for these two, I think we should see it. I mean, the last two fights have been so controversial. Even though Estrada won them, and that usually closes out a rivalry, I mean, Estrada won them so controversially. I mean, most people had the last fight in favor of Chocolatito. In this fight, I'm not sure yet, but I felt that Chocolatito won it. So that's one person there, myself, that thinks that Chocolatito won, and I'm pretty sure a lot of other people think that Chocolatito won this fight as well. So, I mean, I wouldn't mind if they actually do a fourth fight. But if he doesn't do a fourth fight, which I could definitely see why they won't do a fourth fight, we could definitely see Estrada, I guess you could say, challenge for more titles at 115 pounds. I mean, you have to remember that this fight was only for one belt since he got stripped of the WBA, and since he was the WBC franchise champion, all that weird stuff. But, yeah, we could definitely see Estrada take on someone in the top 10 in his next fight, if not have a quadrilogy fight with Chocolatito. But as for Roman Gonzalez losing here for the fourth time in his career, this is a very tough loss considering how I thought he won it and how it was really, really close in terms of, I mean, I guess you could say in a broad spectrum on how many people would have it, because I'm pretty sure, I mean, if there was a poll to say who won this fight, it'd be really, really close. I mean, I personally think that Chocolatito won it, obviously, as I mentioned earlier. But, I mean, the thing is, for Chocolatito, he's still a world-class fighter, still a top-tier fighter at his weight. So I think that he'll continue on facing these top guys. I think in his next fight, we could see him face someone in the top 5, top 10 at this weight. And maybe he too could challenge for a world title as well. Maybe facing Joshua Franco. Maybe even for Estrada too, he could face Joshua Franco, who's actually the brother of Jesse Rodriguez. But Rodriguez was obviously campaigning heavily at 115 pounds. He had this title that Estrada just won here, but he moved down, I believe, to 112. So yeah, now the weight's even more open. And we could even see maybe even Chocolatito have another fight with Siraciket Srongvisai. Now, the Srongvisai is undefeated versus Chocolatito, but who knows? We could see that, or we could see, I mean, just there's a lot of fights that could be made for both these guys, and I think they should have some big fights next. So overall, Juan Francisco Estrada once again defeats Roman Chocolatito Gonzalez, this time winning by majority decision in a fight that I actually thought that Chocolatito won. But like I said, comment down below how you scored the fight. And yeah, that's really it. I'm MB Boxing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.